Hello dear students, welcome you all in our today's lecture of our pay block elements. Okay, so in lastly we discussed whatever regarding ozone and all, means chemistry of oxygen and its compounds in previous lecture we saw. Okay, now in today's lecture we will talking about chemistry of sulfur and its compounds. Okay, so be ready with this content. It is also very much important part of our pay block elements, chemistry of sulfur and its compounds. See here, chemistry of sulfur and its compounds. Okay, now whenever we are discussing about sulfur, so at that time you must know we will discuss about occurrence of that. Okay, so generally we discuss total 4 to 6.5% near about weight it is oxygen is present on earth crust. Okay, now what will be the percentage of sulfur on the earth crust? So see, near about beta here 0.05% by weight of sulfur is present on earth crust. Okay, now it occurs, whatever this sulfur, it occurs in both the states. Okay, so which beta free as well as what beta combined state. Now see, suppose hum abhi baat kare free states ki, so how it will occurs in your free state. Okay, so beta whatever your sulfur in free state, we call it as a what? Yes, very good. It is present in free state, sulfur in free state occurs by volcanic, say here, by volcanic eruption, by volcanic eruptions. Okay, and it will some areas in what, one region, volcanic region we can say, it is in Italy, some parts of India, okay, then South America, Japan and Russia. So there whatever your sulfur is occur in free state. Okay, now how it will occur and where it will occur in what, combined state. So suppose hum abhi baat kare sulfur in combined state. So beta sulfur in combined state, it is where occurred? Yes, it will occurs in the form of like this, see, sulfides.
What beta?
Sulfides and sulfates, etc. Okay, now these are what we discuss general introductory part of your sulfur. Okay, now we will discuss on what are allotropes of sulfur. So pay attention, it is very much important. Okay, so write down beta allotropes of sulfur. Allotropes of sulfur. So in the allotropes of sulfur, how many total allotropes of sulfur? There are three total main important allotropes of sulfur. Okay, so see here, we will discuss first beta, write down rhombic. Okay, second beta your monoclinic sulfur. ठीक है, third से यार plastic sulfur. ठीक है, so these are different allotropes of sulfur. So here we will discuss beta what? We will discuss one by one. Okay. That is first rhombic. What beta? Rhombic. Say rhombic. Or we can say as alpha sulfur. Rhombic sulfur is upon diamond. Alpha sulfur. It is also called alpha sulfur. Okay. So write down here few lines regarding this. It is the most stable form of sulfur at room temperature. It is most stable form of sulfur. Yes, at the room temperature. Room temperature. Okay. Now, whatever your rhombic sulfur. See, rhombic sulfur exists as what, beta? Yes, rhombic sulfur exists as a set molecule. As you know, how your whatever sulfur it exists. Yes, sulfur exists as a yes. Your what? So many types to these are what, beta? Acid here. Okay. I hope you understood this thing regarding your rhombic, or we can say alpha sulfur. Okay. So acid molecule, we will draw, we already drawn this as like this crown shape structure. So see here, beta, how we can draw. Yes, as you know better. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Crown shape acid molecule. Okay. Now second हम अभी बात करते हैं. Second we will discuss what, beta? Monoclinic. Monoclinic sulfur की. So here in monoclinic sulfur. And this monoclinic sulfur or what, beta? Yes, beta sulfur. Beta sulfur. Okay. Now it is prepared by, how it is prepared? It is prepared by melting rhombic sulfur. How it is prepared? Yes, it is prepared by, yes, melting what, beta? Melting rhombic sulfur. ठीक है, जब ऊपर वाले को इसको अभी हम हीट करें तो वो क्या बन जाता है? मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर. ओके, मेल्टिंग रोम्बिक सल्फर इन अ डिश. ओके, इन अ डिश. And what will form, beta? Yes, forming a crust-like structure. Crust means apan mhanto kay, kavach tayar hote. Theek hai. Now your whatever monoclinic sulfur also exists as, monoclinic sulfur also exists as, yes, beta, acid molecule. Yes, monoclinic sulfur also exists as your acid molecule. Okay, so now very much important thing about your whatever this monoclinic sulfur and all. Okay, about at the what temperature it is stable and how it will transform into one into another. So this part is very much important. So you concentrate on this about what, beta? Monoclinic sulfur, or we can say yes, beta sulfur. Concentrate. I hope you wrote this all content here clearly. Okay. So see here about your what? Monoclinic sulfur. So beta. Monoclinic. Whatever our second monoclinic sulfur or what, beta? Beta sulfur ठीक है, वी सॉ हाउ इट इज प्रिपेयर्ड एंड इन द मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्म व्हाट इज सेड लाइक योर फर्स्ट दैट इज अ रोम्बिक सल्फर.
ठीक है, नाउ वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू राइट हियर. ओके,
एंड ऑन द बेस ऑफ दिस question will ask right like that we saw in previous contain are you remembering this phosphorus containing compounds. Okay, in that we discuss what structures phosphorus acid, phosphoric acid, okay, phosphinic acid, hypophosphorus acid, pyrophosphoric acid. So in that somewhere you need to revise how many bonds it is directly bonded with either O or either your OH. Okay, it is also means on the basis of that also question will come. Okay, suppose in H3PO4 that is phosphoric acid, how many P double bond O bond are present in that acid? How many P single bond OH are present? Okay, like that questions they will ask. Okay, so you concentrate on these also. ठीक है, नाउ वी विल मूव टुवर्ड्स व्हाट एवर मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर और वी कैन से व्हाट बेटा. यस बेटा सल्फर, सी हियर व्हाट विल बी द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग रिगार्डिंग योर यस बेटा सल्फर. सी हियर मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर, मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर, ठीक है, मोनोक्लिनिक सल्फर stable above 369 kelvin, stable above 369 kelvin and it transform into alpha sulfur, transform into alpha sulfur below this temperature. So beta, these are very much important line, important statement regarding your monoclinic sulfur. Okay, I hope you understood this clearly. Now conversely, suppose we are going to write here. ठीक है, so we will write about your alpha sulfur. ठीक है, so what will happen, alpha sulfur is stable below 369 kelvin and transform into what? Yes, beta sulfur transform into what beta? Beta sulfur above this temperature. Conversely, above this temperature, or we can say vice versa. Say, understood this whatever important contain. Okay, therefore at 369 kelvin, or we can say thus at 369 kelvin, both the forms are stable and coexist and therefore this temperature we call it as a what, and coexist, therefore this temperature we call it as a what beta? Yes, transition temperature. Therefore this temperature we call it as a transition, what beta? Temperature. Okay, I hope you understood this all. you need to write this all clearly. Okay.
So see here, we will discuss regarding plastic sulfur. Third one. Okay. So this thing is very much important.
See about your third. Third is what, beta? Yes. Plastic sulfur.
Okay, so this plastic sulfur, first it is obtained by, so how it is obtained, how it is prepared, that we will say. It is obtained by pouring molten sulfur.
It is obtained by pouring
molten.
See here, by pouring molten sulfur,
okay, into cold water.
Into what, beta? Cold water.
Okay. And when a soft rubber like mass we got,
so that mass we call it as a, plastic sulfur. Okay. Understood.
So you have to write this completely.
So we can say here as a property for this plastic sulfur, it is soft and elastic. What, beta? It is soft and
elastic. In the beginning,
but hardness on standing. But hardness, or we can say hard. It become hard on standing.
Okay.
And gradually changes into rhombic sulfur. Rhombic sulfur.
Okay, I hope you understood this regarding plastic sulfur, how it is obtained. Okay, so this is a property also,
or we can say regarding plastic sulfur, beta. See here, plastic sulfur is, we can mention here one more property, that is plastic sulfur is what? Yes, plastic sulfur is super cool liquid. Is what, beta? Super cooled liquid.
As you know, there is another example also of super cool liquid.
Yes, very good. Glass is what? Super cool liquid. Okay.
See here, regarding, we will discuss one more allotrope of sulfur. We will discuss in short.
You can draw the structure of that. That is cyclo S6.
What, beta?
Cyclo S6.
Cyclo S6. Okay, so see here
how we can prepare their structure as like this. Okay.
Cyclo S6 bond angle also we can mention 102.2 degree. Okay, so these are what, beta?
Cyclo S6. You can draw it. It is
also very much important. You must know what it is, cyclo S6 and all. Okay,
so beta, now we will move towards important compound of
sulfur. Okay, that is, yes, as you know, what beta? Sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide. So pay attention on this. Sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide. So already we discussed structures also. SO2, sulfur dioxide. Okay. Now we will discuss about their preparation of what? Preparation of sulfur dioxide. First we will discuss about the laboratory preparation. Okay. So write down that first reaction of your preparation, or we can say laboratory preparation of your sulfur dioxide. Okay, so when how it will form? Yes, when we done reaction with your sodium sulfide with the dilute H2SO4, dilute H2SO4, or we can say what, aqueous, okay, H2SO4. So then you will get what? See, we will say here, see beta, Na2SO3 plus H2SO4 H2SO4 aqueous, then obviously what will come? Ata tumhala beta je kai reactant hai tya reactant varun product easily identify karta ala pahije. For example, suppose I wrote here what, this reactant. Means you have to justify what will be the products. And as you know, in previously session we discussed regarding your metal with concentrated nitric acid reaction, okay, metal with a concentrated sulfuric acid reaction. Means if suppose we are taking example of your copper with nitric acid, concentrated nitric acid, no doubt that byproduct you have to keep in mind. But at least main product you must know. Suppose copper plus nitric acid is there. So always what beta, possibility of formation of copper nitrate, that is cupric nitrate, CuNO3 twice. And other byproducts are depends on whether you are concentrated nitric acid or whether you are using dilute nitric acid. So ye abhi judgment or ye justify what? तुम्हाला हे जमलंच पाहिजे आता, ठीक आहे, रिएक्टंटवरून प्रॉडक्ट जस्टिफाय करणं, ठीक आहे. सो सी हियर, Na2SO3 अँड H2SO4 इज देअर. सो व्हॉट विल हॅपन बेटा? येस, युअर बाय प्रॉडक्ट इज व्हॉट, सोडियम सल्फेट अलॉंग विथ यू विल गेट व्हॉट, युअर SO2. मीन्स व्हॉट एवर दिस सल्फाइड इज कन्वर्टेड टू सल्फेट, ऑलरेडी वी कॅन कॉल इट इज व्हॉट, H2SO4 इज अ ऑक्सिडायझिंग एजंट. So it convert SO3 2 minus into what? SO4 2 minus. Then here you will get what? Yes, you will get Na2SO4 plus SO2 plus H2. Now you are work to balance this reaction. Okay? Understood, beta? Okay? I hope you understood. Now we can say this reaction as a what? This reaction as a molecular equation. What beta? Molecular equation. Now we will write of this reaction as a ionic form. So it is also very much interesting. Okay, pay attention on this interesting part. See, SO3 2 minus. This is SO3 2 minus. Okay, plus H plus, 2H plus. Acidic acids are what? They are giving always the protons. Okay, now it will convert into what? Oxidizing agent, oxidation. So sulfide, but what it is beta? Yes, sulfide ion, and with the help of oxidizing agent it will be converted into your sulfate ion, as like this, SO4 2 minus plus this H2O. Okay, I hope you understood this. ठीक आहे, Now here we not use we here not use whatever sulfate ion. So beta, here product is what?
SO2. Understood.
So you can balance also beta easily. Okay. You will get a balance. Means see, one is 3 oxygen, this 3 oxygen, these 2 hydrogen, these 2 hydrogen. Means this our reaction is balanced. Now
about atom and charges.
Atoms are balanced, then what will about charge? See here, what will about charge beta? Charge here 2 negative, here 2 positive charge. So 2 negative, 2 positive, 0, and here also 0. Means whatever AC is what? A for atom, C for charge. First we balance atom, then we balance charge. I hope you understood this thing. And it's very much important to balance this ionic reaction, whether it is in acidic medium or whether it is in basic medium. Okay, and as you know, one more knowledge you know of this in acidic medium, what we need to add, and in basic medium, what we have to add. Okay, in acidic medium, we are adding what? H plus and H2O. And in basic medium, we are adding what? OH minus and your water. Okay. So this thing you already discussed, you already studied in redox reaction. Okay, that's why I told your redox reaction, this topic is depends on, means why it is important that redox reaction, because on this redox reaction 4 to 5 topics depends. Okay, understood. So I hope you understood this ionic reaction also. Now we will discuss next method also. Say it can also be prepared by in laboratory by heating copper with concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay, by heating copper with what beta? Yes, concentrated sulfuric acid. So what will be the here product? Simple, your copper and sulfuric acid is there. So beta, obviously your copper sulfate is a product, and byproduct whatever your sulfur dioxide along with water. So like that justification we required. असं केल्याने काय होईल, तुमची जी काही थिंकिंग कॅपॅसिटी आहे रिॲक्शन फास्ट करण्याची, ठीक आहे, ती इन्क्रीज होईल. अँड यू विल गेट कॉन्फिडन्स इन इनऑर्गॅनिक केमिस्ट्री. ठीक आहे, बेसिकली इट इज अ व्हेरी मच इझी पार्ट इनऑर्गॅनिक केमिस्ट्री. अंडरस्टूड? ऑल रिॲक्शन यू हॅव टू डू थरली. सी, so what I told, yes, about copper sulfate plus what? SO2 plus H2O. Now beta, I am giving here a few seconds to balance this reaction. Okay, you can balance. So see here, constant H2 support, so here 2. Okay, and here also beta, your 2. Yes, it is balanced here. Okay, I hope you understood this also. Now beta, here how we prepare industrially our sulfur dioxide. So we will discuss that also part, how you will prepare industrially sulfur dioxide. Okay, see, industrially is prepared, it is produced byproduct of roasting of sulfides. Roasting of sulfides. So that roasting and calcination, I think you already discussed, you already this over roasting and calcination in 10th standard. Okay, in metallurgical operations, metallurgical process, it is over. Okay, so further we are dealing
ते आपल्याला परत बघायचं आहे, व्हॉट एवर कॅल्सिनेशन, रोस्टिंग, मेटलर्जिकल ऑपरेशन, परत आपल्याला बघायचं आहे त्या एका टॉपिकमध्ये. नेम ऑफ दॅट टॉपिक, जनरल प्रिन्सिपल अँड आयसोलेशन ऑफ प्रोसेसेस ऑफ एलिमेंट्स, ऑर वी कॅन से इन शॉर्ट मेटलर्जी. इन शॉर्ट व्हॉट बेटा? मेटलर्जी. ठीक आहे,
सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दिस कॅल्सिनेशन अँड रोस्टिंग, वी विल से.
जस्ट नाउ वी नीड ऑफ अवर सल्फर डायऑक्साइड, सो इंडस्ट्रियली इट इज अ बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ व्हॉट?
येस, रोस्टिंग ऑफ सल्फाइड ओर्स. ओके, सच अज व्हॉट बेटा? से व्हॉट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट हियर?
FeS plus O2, that gives what? Yes, obviously here what form? Fe2O3, one of the stable binary product, plus obviously what beta?
SO2. Now we need to balance this reaction. You can also balance easily, or you can cross check. Any doubt will come, you can what? Share immediately.
Okay, regarding balance C and others also. ठीक आहे,
सी वन्स क्रॉस चेक. ओके,
नाऊ दीज आर वन ओवर, विथ हेल्प ऑफ अनदर ओवर ऑल्सो वी कॅन प्रिपेअर आवर सल्फर डायऑक्साइड, सो पे अटेन्शन ऑन दॅट. ZnS, ठीक आहे,
ZnS ऑक्सिडाइज,
सो इट गिव्ह वॉट? ऑब्विसली ZnO प्लस युअर SO2.
So beta, you can balance here SO2, 2S here, 2 here, 2, 4 and 6 here, 3. I hope you understood this reaction clearly and you done balancing also of this reaction. Okay,
now see here beta, what will be the about chemical properties? Okay, and whatever physical property you just see, it is very much easy. You can do from your modules also, and or you have that your NCERT also. Okay, physical property, whatever it is, colorless, their density, okay, their order, like that. So we'll discuss here chemical properties. In this chemical properties, we will discuss what beta?
Yes, acidic character.
So pay attention. Chemical properties. Regarding chemical properties, we will discuss beta acidic character. Yes, acidic character.
Now in acidic character, see here,
as you know beta, when your sulfur dioxide, okay, when your sulfur dioxide dissolve in water, and as you know what you will get, we already discussed H2SO3, that is your sulfurous acid. Sulfurous acid, it is in what beta? Obviously it is in aqueous, because these are liquid, water in liquid. Now see here, one more important property of our what sulfur dioxide, it is when our this sulfur dioxide gas, when we bubble through calcium sulfide, through lime water, through lime water, when we pass our sulfur dioxide gas, then what we will get? You will get milkiness, and that milkiness is of what? Calcium sulfide. And when on this milkiness you again pass your excess, if you pass excess again whatever your sulfur dioxide, then you will get what? Calcium bisulfide. And it is obviously what? That milkiness become disappear. Okay,
I think one more same reaction as we
as you discussed, you studied in your 10th standard. Okay, first white precipitate, then that precipitate dissolves, okay, like that. Understood. But it is in word. When we pass you to yes. Okay, are you remembering this? Okay, and that first that product is for calcium carbonate, then after that for calcium hydrogen bicarbonate. Like that, here we have to pass what your sulfur dioxide gas. So pay attention on this reaction. Okay, see what this reaction are saying. When we pass sulfur dioxide gas through what beta? Calcium hydroxide CaOH twice. Okay, CaOH twice plus SO2, then you will get what? CaSO3, calcium sulfide plus H2O. And here we can say as a milkiness. What beta? Milkiness here occur. And when we pass again what? Sulfur dioxide gas through this solution, then you will get what? You will get calcium hydrogen sulfide, or we can say what? Calcium bisulfide, as like this. Calcium bisulfide, okay? Or this milkiness is disappear. Milkiness disappears. Okay, I hope you understood this reaction clearly. If any doubt will come, you can discuss immediately without wasting time. Okay, so these are what all about your acidic character. Now one more, if you are considering when your sulfur dioxide reacts with halogens, then after this what will happen, what will be the possibility of product here, so we will discuss this. In this chemical properties only beta, we have to discuss. Okay, so concentrate. Say here, combination with halogens of your sulfur dioxide. Combination with halogens. How your sulfur dioxide combines with what? Yes, combines with your halogen, and what they are giving us. When your this sulfur dioxide reacts with, say, when your this sulfur dioxide reacts with chlorine gas in the presence of charcoal as a catalyst. What beta? Charcoal as a catalyst. You will get what? You will get SO2Cl2. So we call it as a sulfuryl chloride. What beta? Sulfuryl chloride you will get. Okay. And having nature is what? Physical nature is liquid. Now here one more remarkable part about this your sulfur dioxide is what? Sulfur dioxide act as a reducing agent. What beta? Sulfur dioxide is act as a reducing agent. So see how it is. Pay attention. Okay. Sulfur dioxide acts as a reducing agent. We can say whatever your SO2 is what? Fairly strong reducing agent in the presence of moisture. Okay. And it reduces your potassium dichromate also. Okay, in acidic medium. Okay, so we will write first beta here molecular equation. So you concentrate on this molecular equation first. So see here, when your K2Cr2O7
plus
H2SO4 plus SO2, then you will get what? You will get, when you pass the sulfur dioxide gas, you will get green colored compound, that is Cr2SO4 thrice plus K2SO4
plus what beta?
H2O. Like this you will get one reaction when you pass your sulfur dioxide through potassium dichromate solution in acidic medium. Okay. Now we will write ionic reaction also of this. Okay. Beta, you can balance like this. So we will write now what ionic equation, ionic reaction. See beta. Cr2O7 2 minus plus what? 2H plus plus 3SO2. That gives what?
Yes, that gives,
see here, 3SO4 2 minus, okay, plus 2Cr3 plus plus what beta? H2O.
Suppose this they give
one reaction. Okay. Now here first beta you write this whole reaction.
Okay.
Write this whole reaction. Now after this we will discuss what, how we can balance with whenever such type of reaction will come in acidic as well as in basic medium. Okay. Your SO2, these are SO2. Okay. SO2 is what? Reducing agent. So it itself oxidizes, therefore it is converted into sulfate ion. And your dichromate is what? Itself oxidized. Madhusra the Gaganar reduction. So see this, your dichromate ion is converted into Cr3 plus along with water. Okay, so now we will discuss this. Okay, how this whole you will get same reaction with equal charges and all. Okay, equal charges and all, how you will, we will balance this. Okay. Now see here, atoms are balanced, no doubt. See the charge also. Okay. Now here 2 minus 2 plus 0. Here what? 3, 2, 6 minus, and this was 3, 2, 6. So 6 plus means 6 plus 6 minus also 0. Okay. I hope you understood this. Means our atom also balance and our charge is also balanced. Now when in 12th standard, how you will get question, you will get this much only.
See,
you will get beta this much only, and they give this much only, and here what? Question mark. So question mark in the sense you have to complete this reaction with appropriate product, with appropriate charges, and with stoichiometric coefficient also. Okay, then and then you will get marks. Okay, understood? So pay attention how you will, we will balance this. Okay, tar baga. So for that we need what? Half reactions. Okay, already beta, you discuss, you solve such type of examples in what? 11th standard redox reaction topic. Okay, so see, first I have to take Cr2O7 2 minus, that gives what? 2Cr3 plus. Okay, understood? So Cr2, 2Cr. Means we need to balance this. What? See, I am writing here. AC, as you know, AC is what? A for atom, C for charge. 2Cr, 2Cr. Here, here 7 oxygen. So we need how many So it is, say, but before this, first it is an acidic medium reaction. So in acidic medium, we are adding what? H plus and water. We are adding H plus and water. So obviously, what will come? Yes, here 7 oxygen, so here what? H2O. Because we need oxygen, so I have to add here H2O, not H plus first. Understood? So 7 oxygen, so I have to take here 7. Understood? So now what? Automatically 7 to the 14. So 14 H plus. I hope you understood this. Now, once you have to cross check Cr2, 2Cr, 7 oxygen, these are 7 oxygen, 14 hydrogen, yes, here also 14 hydrogen. Now what? Our atom is balanced. Now what? Now it's time to balance your charges. C for charges. So see here, 2, 3 are 6, here 6 charge total, here what? 2 minus and this 14, so beta 14 minus 2, here total means LHS total 12 charge, and here total RHS, LHS 12, RHS 6. So we need to balance somewhere this. So how we can balance beta? Yes, we can balance as like this. So see here, whether here means for the balancing, we need to add electrons. So where we have to add electrons? Either here or here. And why? So see here, here total 12, here 6. So पहिल्यांदा आपल्याला चेक करायचं की रिडक्शन झालंय का ऑक्सिडेशन झालेलं आहे. ठीक आहे, तर तुम्हाला माहिती असेल की Cr2O7 2- मध्ये ह्या सीआरचा ऑक्सिडेशन नंबर किती असतो? प्लस 6. ठीक आहे, आणि ह्या इथे सिंगल सीआरचा ऑक्सिडेशन नंबर किती आहे? तर प्लस 3 आहे. समजलं? म्हणजे बेटा 6 to 3+ गेलेलं आहे. 6 to 3+ चार्ज गेलेलं आहे म्हणजे काय झालेलं आहे? रिडक्शन. सो रिडक्शन मीन्स वॉट? गेनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. So with a gaining of electron means your electrons will add LHS. So how much? Yes, beta, very good. Plus 6 electron minus. Plus what, beta? 6 electron minus. I hope you understood this. It is very, very much important reaction. Okay? Understood? Say. Now, our this one half reaction is balanced. Okay, now you can observe here also 6, here also 12 minus 6. So here also 6, means in both the cases 6 are there. Okay, now yes, very good. Now we have to take our sulfide, whatever sulfide dioxide. So SO2 is converted into what? SO4 means itself reducing agent means what? Itself oxidized, others काय करणार? रिडक्शन ते केलेले ऑलरेडी बघा. सो 4 2-, सो हियर 2 ऑक्सिजन, हियर 4. सो हियर हाऊ मच? वी हॅव टू ॲड 2H2O. सो वी आर ऑब्झर्विंग हियर 2H2O, 2 ऑक्सिजन ऑन देअर, बट नाऊ 4 हायड्रोजन. सो वी हॅव टू नीड टू ॲड 4H+. सो ॲज लाईक दिस. सो सियर सी, once we will cross check our atom is balanced or not. One sulfur, okay, 2 oxygen, this 2, 4 oxygen, here also 4 oxygen, 4 hydrogen, yes, our atoms are balanced. Now it's time to balance what? Charge. So pay attention on this charge. Here beta 2 minus, here 4 plus, so 4 plus minus 2, 2 electrons. So beta, how and where we have to add? Means here total 2 negative charge, here what? 0. It is oxidation. So oxidation means what? Loss of electrons. So I need to add here only electron. Understood? I hope you understood this thing clearly. Okay? Pay attention, very much important. Same reaction will occur, will come in your what? DNA block element also. So pay attention carefully. Once you understood this, you can deal any reaction of this type. Okay?
See here. 4 plus minus 2, 2. And here 0 charge, here no charge. So I need to add electron 2. So it becomes 2 plus and these 2 electron become 0. Now here also 0 charge, here also 0 charge. Now what?
We have to cancel out electrons.
Beta, here 6 electrons are there, here 2. So I need to multiply here with 3. With 3. So I will write again. You have to write it again. I am doing here only. So see, 2, 3, 2 are 6. So 6 is 2 here. 3SO2, yes. 3SO4, 2 minus, correct. 3, 4 are 12 hydrogen, okay. 3, 2 are 6. Got? Understood? Okay, so beta, here 6 electron minus. And here also your 6 electron minus. Okay. Now this 6 electron and this 6 electron will cancel out each other. Now beta, yes, what will happen? See here. Now you need to add whatever reactant side, reactant bajula lihayche, product side, product cha bajula lihayche. Okay. So baguya apan. Baga. CR2, no problem. तुम्ही H plus जरी पहिला दिला तरी पण काही प्रॉब्लेम नाही. ठीक आहे. CR2O2 minus plus. Now see 14 and 12. How difference you have to write? Keep in mind. 2H plus plus. Okay. 3SO2. Okay. Now I आता आपण ह्या बाजूला H plus लिहिले म्हणजे ह्या बाजूला काय लिहायला लागणार आपल्याला? Water. ठीक आहे. सही. This reaction. Now say here, beta, 2Cr3 plus, plus what beta? Yes, 7H2O, here 6H2O. Difference is the X, I mean, 1H2O. Okay, plus what? 3SO4, 2 minus. Now beta, you compare your this reaction and this reaction. You will get answer easily. Understood? Now you have to write this properly. Okay? Beta, you have to write this properly. I hope you understood this reaction all. Now we will discuss some other reactions also. Okay? पॉज करून तुम्ही हे कम्प्लिटली व्यवस्थित लिहून घ्या बिकॉज इट इज व्हेरी मच इम्पॉर्टंट अँड व्हॉट एवर आय टोल्ड ड्युरिंग एक्सप्लेनिंग दॅट ऑल्सो यू रिवाइज अँड वर्क ऑन दॅट. ठीक आहे. आय होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. नाऊ सी हियर नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस. ठीक आहे. नाऊ आय डन दिस वन रिएक्शन. नाऊ यू हॅव टू डू अनदर रिएक्शन. सो सी हियर बेटा. Ready?
I will give you here one ionic reaction. You have to do and you have to share that images on WhatsApp. It is compulsory to all students. You have to share your answer and whatever difficulty arises, you have to discuss during doubt session. I will explain. Okay? Surely. Okay?
So see here, that reaction I will write here. And you have to complete that reaction.
Okay, so see here. So write beta that reaction. 2MnO4 minus plus 5SO2.
Okay.
Plus what beta? 2H2O. Okay. Next, 2SO4, 2 minus. Plus 2Mn plus 2 plus what? 4H plus. फोर एच प्लस. बेटा आता मी तुम्हाला रिएक्शन दिलेली आहे, तुम्हाला हे काय करायचं आहे, वॉट हाऊ आय सॉल्व हिअर विथ हाफ रिएक्शन मेथड लाईक दॅट यू हॅव टू सॉल्व अँड यू हॅव टू शेअर युअर डाऊट्स. ठीक आहे, अंडरस्टूड. मीन्स हिअर वॉट विल हॅपन वेन वी पास दिस युअर सल्फर डायऑक्साईड गॅस थ्रू दिस पोटॅशियम परमँगनेट सोल्युशन. वन मोर इम्पॉर्टंट हिअर ऑब्झर्वेशन यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व. ओके,
जे काय ऑब्झर्व कराल ते
बघा, काय ऑब्झर्व कराल तुम्ही. वेन यू पास दिस सल्फर डायऑक्साईड सोल्युशन थ्रू दिस पोटॅशियम परमँगनेट सोल्युशन, वॉट एवर दिस सल्फर डायऑक्साईड गॅस, वॉट एवर आय यू नो युअर पोटॅशियम परमँगनेट कलर इज वॉट? येस, व्हायलेट पिंक कलर. अँड दॅट व्हायलेट पिंक कलर इज डिकलराइज बाय पासिंग दिस सल्फर डायऑक्साईड गॅस.
ओके,
अंडरस्टूड. अँड दीज आर द प्रॉडक्ट ऑफ दिस रिॲक्शन. अँड वी हॅव टू बॅलन्स विथ दिस वॉट एवर युअर आयन्स.
ओके,
हाऊ दॅट स्टॉइचोमेट्रिक कोएफिशियंट हिअर 2 विल कम, हिअर 4 विल कम, यू हॅव टू टेल मी लाईक दॅट हाऊ आय टोल्ड प्रिव्हियस वन. ओके, लाईक दॅट यू हॅव टू डू इन युअर नोटबुक अँड
शेअर युअर दॅट इमेजेस. ठीक आहे,
now one more also you can write beta when you are this ferric sulfate. So see here, Fe3 plus plus SO2 plus H2O. So this, as you know, sulfur dioxide itself oxidizes, dusre to kay karnar hai reduction. So obviously this Fe3 plus is reduces to what? Fe2 plus, and this SO2 is oxidized to what? So for 2 minus, I hope you understood this, plus how much beta? 4H plus. Okay, like that you can balance this reaction.
Okay, now one more remarkable
statement also we will discuss here
about one more reaction we will discuss here.
When you are PbO2 plus SO2, so surely it will be converted into what? PbSO4, lead sulfate. Okay, and when you are on sodium peroxide, if you pass your sulfur dioxide, yes surely what? Na2SO4. Okay, now see here, we will discuss uses of the sulfur dioxides. So you can write uses of this our sulfur dioxide, how it will be. Beta, sulfur dioxide is what is used as a preservative in jams, jellies, squashes. Okay, now whatever sulfur dioxide used in refining of petroleum products and sugar also. Third one, it is act as a disinfectant and germicides also. Okay, then anti-chlore. It is used as an anti-chlore agent. Okay, your sulfur dioxide. Anti-chlore means what? It will help to remove what? Excess of chlorine from bleached ones, or we can say bleached articles. Anti-chlore agent, sulfur dioxide is what? Anti-chlore agent. Very much important statement. So you have to write this uses also, whatever I told. Okay, so I hope you understood this all content of today's lecture. Our any doubt will come, so beta you can feel free to ask anytime. So take care and stay safe. Thank you very much.